Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Asgard, and welcome back to Tales of Berseria. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Asgard, and welcome back to Tales of Berseria. So, when we left off, we made it here to this place, and I can't remember the name of it. Beardsley, the snow-covered hamlet. I actually don't know. Does she have any different hunts? No, okay. But anyways, we made it here. We're kind of making our way through Helavies right now, or around, the area around Helavies, and we're supposed to be heading up north to. Oh, there's the mountain up there. I never noticed that. It's like a snow-covered volcano. That's cool. But anyways, we have this mini game we want to check out. So let's see if we can really handle a geo board. Let's play Coin Collector. And I think it's probably pretty self-explanatory. That speeds us up. I don't know if I can, truly handle a geo board. Whoop! That didn't help much. Okay. Gosh. Oh my god. This is terrible. I am pro geo board. Oh wow. If I can get turning straight. Oh my god. Oh man, I don't know about this. I don't know if we're gonna how we're gonna do on this, but this is so bad. Oh, I feel like this would actually be a little bit easier with a controller, honestly. Oh man, time's up. All right, well, we did bad. We got 84 new records. Yeah, because there was nothing there. We got 94 Tails coins. Let's see. Do they give me anything for that? Let's do this again, meow. Okay. Let's try this again. Let's try to at least get 100. Yeah, target score is. Oh, whoops. I guess I could just hoof it. That might actually be easier in some points, but. Like right here. It might be a little bit easier if I would actually, like, get off the board for a second and at least line myself up. Okay, I am not such a good geo boarder, I think. Okay, if I left click, it'll boost me. Like that. Okay. Oh man, yeah, I don't know if we're gonna beat that last score or not. Eighty-eight. I got four more. Okay. That's 98 Tails coins. Let's try this one more time. This is tough. I'm just gonna say that. This is very, very tough. There's 120 total that you can get. Like, I use my boost and I like don't get anything in the whole process of it. I'm good at dodging the coins. I'm not good at actually hitting them. Oh, I did it. I did it. Yes, I got 103 out of 120 that time. I think that was like my fifth attempt. New record. 213 Tails coins earned. Okay. What did we get? Wow, you are one with the geo board. Take this as a reward, meow. We got the bedhead. For those who don't sweat the small stuff, let them call you a slob. Let's do this again. Is there another one? Okay, no, there's not. Okay, let's see what they've got on item exchange real quick. Looks like mainly the same stuff. What's over here? Okay, nothing that we want. Bienfu hat for Eleanor. I guess we're gonna continue cleaning out this page. So we're gonna get the battle music garb for Mogilu. Okay. So let's see what that bedhead is. Oh, is there different geo boards? What? Really? That's gonna be amazing. If we can get additional geo boards. Okay, the bedhead. Okay, it adds if you notice up there at the top, it adds that little piece of hair there. Okay. Put Mogilu into her battle music garb. All right, so let's check, I guess, Dial's Cave. Really quick. Oh, there is a geo board spot like right. ahead of us. I have no interest in fighting any of you guys. Okay. Let's go to the depths. If there's anything, chances are it's going to be in the depths and not, you know, in the middle. Okay, it looks like there's nothing. Oh, but that herb has respawned. Lavender. That's extra 2 attack. I was hitting I because, like, okay, in this game, E is the inventory and I does nothing. And then in Davria that I've been playing, I is the inventory and E is your heal button. And so there was a couple points today when I was doing Davria that I was hitting E to try to open my inventory because I'm so accustomed to the Tails inventory button. And it made me waste an Eternal Stone. I was like, no! Because that game, you only get 3 of them until you rest at a shrine. So, which if you guys have ever played Dark Souls, it's a lot like Dark Souls. It's honestly, it's an amazing game. I'm having so much fun with that series and everything. So if you guys haven't checked it out, you know, if you've ever played Dark Souls, if you like Dark Souls, I do highly suggest it. But, you know, there's a series going on for that if you're interested.
No guards. I think it's a good thing or a bad thing.
I'd say good. We can march straight in.
Yes, we can. If you recall, we actually came up here a long, long time ago. And they were like, you can't pass here. Like, it's blocked off or whatever. And they wouldn't let us through, so... Let's go ahead and push on. Oh, is this a... Yeah, I guess this is a dungeon. I see some guards up here that are probably going to fight us. I can only imagine. Oh, I see some kind of spirits here, too. Roving spirits. They are level 52, have a little over 11,000 hit points. Weak to earth and wind, resistant to fire. All right. Okay. Seems like they attack similar to the mages that we've encountered in the past, but their spells, instead of being like the full field, their spells are directed at a specific member of the party. But they are, I love these kind of enemies though, because you run up on them, you smack them a couple times, and you've got them stun locked and you get a soul from it. It's great. Oh, Aizen just took a beating.
I can't die here.
And so did I. They do a lot of damage. They really do. They do an absolute ton of damage. So you don't want to get hit by those spells, that's for sure. And I'm about to take one.
No.
Oh my gosh. Look at this. I mean, they are wrecking our party right now. So bad. This is so bad.
Is that all you got?
No,
I can't.
Oh my gosh. Aizen's the only one left. Get somebody up, Aizen. Too slow. This is so bad. This is so bad. Too slow. Oh my gosh. They are just railing us.
I can't die here.
Oh my god, it's so bad. Like that. I don't even know how you're supposed to dodge that because I'm running.
Leave this.
And it gets me.
Devour. Crash through.
God. Look at all this damage! Oh my gosh! That is our very first game over ever. That is our very first. Oh my gosh! We have never been railed so bad. Like, they're just like, what's up? Get you some death up in here.
Look, no guards. I think it's a good thing or a bad thing.
Alright, let's try this again. What about this guy? Undying Wretch. It's a level 41, 12,000 HP normally. We got a favorable encounter, so. Oh my gosh, more spellcasters? Really? Oh man. These guys aren't so bad. Well, something's coming. It's probably going to hurt. I may not want to link these battles right out the gate like that here. Okay. That wasn't a linked battle. So.
Unarmed.
410 XP.
Deadly weapons.
There is no way I can go here and not link. Okay, there is Argent Armor, level 52, 9,440 HP. It's weak to physical. Okay. I'm about to take some damage. Oh, man. Oh, my God. It's like they all focus one person. It's in the middle of a combo or something and just body them. Yeah, forget that pain and move. Oh my god. So much damage! I'm about to eat it right here. I think. Oh, thank you for the heal. And I still die. Like, their heal spells don't heal for enough to really output enough that stops, like, these supercasters from just wrecking you. I'm about to change up some party strats, is what I'm about to do. Because I don't think we can do this with our current party strats at all. This battle took forever.
To fall here.
Almost 2.5 minutes. We got 3,481 XP for it, though. Oh, man. This place is just tough. Like, that's all there is to it. It is just a difficult area. Actually, before we do this, let's check strategies. And I'm going to set Lafayette to be defensive. I'm going to tell... Let's see, who do we have? See, I wish they'd quit switching. I don't want Aizen. I want
Mogulay. Miss me that much, did ya?
I'm actually going to set their blast gauges. Like, I'm going to say, you use Mystic Art. I don't want him to change it out. So we're going to say, you use Mystic Art. And Rokuro, use Mystic Art. I don't want them changing out. It drives me insane. It's okay for, like, certain areas. But here, I want this team. I want Lafayette, I want Mogulu, I want Rokuro. And I want Mogulu to be defensive. Okay. So, there we go. And keep distance. And I'm going to tell him to interfere with enemy arts. Rokuro is going to focus on enemy arts. Lafayette's focusing on enemy arts. She's going to AoE. And then I'm going to do my thing. So maybe this will make this area a little bit easier. Because it's when all those art casters just start blasting us down. Is when we start dying. Okay, it seems like Rokuro is doing his job. Or Lafayette's doing it, but I have a feeling it's probably Rokuro. Rokuro is a lot more suited for stopping enemy casts than Lafayette is. Because Lafayette's going to be healing more than anything.
Rise, next
And it seems like once nobody's casting, Rokuro just kind of does his normal stuff. He was focused on rear enemies, which is basically like he's going to go after whatever's the farthest from Velvet. It seems like, but we don't want that. We want him to get on those casters, because those casters were what was wrecking us. That was a lot smoother. Alright. Lafayette leveled up. Good stuff. Okay. And our expedition has come back again. Still not. I did it one time at the start. You know, before I started recording, I went ahead and did it. Still didn't get the item. It's like... it's never going to give it to us, I swear. Alright. What do we got here? Cat spirits. 320 to open it. Cool. Found the cats. And we got the Fire Norman hat for Velvet. And the Flame Norman suit for Velvet. Good stuff. Okay. Yeah, if you're not a double battle, I'm not interested. No thanks. I like my double battles. And we got a chest here. Arcane bottle. Up to 5 of those. Flamestone chip. If we come across a tough boss, we'll definitely be popping those though. Which after the encounters when we first got in here, like that's the first time I've had to actually go and like really adjust strategy and stuff. Yeah, I want you and you together. There we
Don't
go.
Waste my time.
This could be a tough battle, but we'll see. Because both the enemies that are here are not easy ones. But it seems like Rokuro's doing his job. Oh, he's stunned though right now. Which could be bad for me. Oh god! That was half my health. A single spell cast. And I lose half my HP. I'm trying to burn this one down real quick. Rokuro's probably got the toughest job, I think, because if he messes up, we're screwed. I mean, I could be the one, I guess, that does all the interrupting. Oh, he missed one, and I lost, like, almost my entire level, or my entire health. Heal me! No! I should have just thrown a health item, because I've got some healing items. Okay. Leave Lafayette. Oh my gosh, Rokuro's down. Somebody has to get him back up. He's very important for these fights. Oh my gosh, I'm about to take it. There we go. I've got to get these casters down ASAP. I've got this one, Rokuro. Deal with the other one that's about to smash me for mega damage. I'm gonna heal myself up here.
Rokuro,
I'm in your debt.
Oh no, I'm gonna heal Rokuro, but that's fine. He needed health too.
I refuse.
Oh my god.
To fall here.
Look at the grade, 0.99. I haven't been getting 0.99 grade in so long. Oh, that just goes to show you how bad we're really doing in these fights. I may have to help him and start stunning as well, I think.
Run away! Crash through!
Oh my gosh. Oh my god, they are just stun locking me until I'm dead.
I can't die here.
And now Rokuro's dead. Somebody get him up. God. Oh man, this is so tough. Okay, I've got a bunch of them stun locked. I'm killing some of them off. Oh my gosh, Rokuro's down again. Oh, come on! Everybody's dying. This is insanity. Oh my god, I'm gonna have to run from this battle. This is too much.
Here.
Can I get out of this? There we go. Oh, Oh my god. Okay, I can't fight those guys. I cannot. I was even trying to stay on disruption and keep them all disrupted, and it's just not enough. When they're just spam casting like that, you just cannot do it. It's insanity. Like, and honestly, they're not squishy. They have a ton of health, an absolute ton of health. So, like, I was over there doing work on them for a bit. And, you know, there was one point I had 4 of them stun locked, and it still wasn't enough. I mean, I was on them, I was doing my job, and Rokuro was going around getting the other ones, but there's just so many of them that there's no way. Maybe once we get, like, some levels under our belt or something. Like, I have felt so over-leveled, and then we get here, and it's just like, no, you're not. Oh, God, look at all the destruction.
I thought we were done for.
Okay, Rokuro and Aizen both leveled up. Rokuro got a couple more levels on his titles. Okay, so we've got... Where do these lead? 2 question marks. Okay, apparently in the Faldi's Ruins, somewhere in here, is the red Nordahl. So we're going to have to keep our eyes open for that. Oh my god. What is this? Are they all exorcists? Some of them look like merchants. There's a town past these ruins. It was probably them. They didn't give me time to read all that, so. Okay, so we can't go in this direction then. We're going to have to go either to the left or to the right. So I'm going to head over, I guess, in this direction. Some kind of a red seal on the door right here. Wish we had our hoverboard. I feel like I move so slow without it. Even though, as you guys saw earlier, I can't drive that thing for nothing. Like, I'm terrible at it. Okay. Alright, the door is open. Oh, man. Okay, these just link together, it looks like. So we've got Lafayette's speculation.
These ruins. This feels like a sad place.
Sad? In what way?
Sorrow permeates this place. As if left behind by people who suffered torment and death. I guess that's a weird impression to get by just looking at some ruins, huh?
I'd trust my feelings if I were you. They'll often lead you to the truth of things. Besides, what you're feeling would explain a thing or two about these ruins.
It would?
Rather than attempting to impress visitors with beauty and opulence, the building and its passageways were built with strength and stability in mind. And that means...
They were anticipating volcanic earthquakes. And they expected that someone might turn violent in these passageways.
Not a bad observation. And what would bring such savage people to these halls? Surely they weren't just passing through.
Then this passage must have led to somewhere. Some room or structure deeper within. A prison for the worst criminals. Or maybe a battle arena.
And that's what gave you a sense of sadness.
If it was an arena, then treasure for the victors might be hidden away somewhere.
Why would it be hidden?
Well, those fighter types might not have been all that nice. And the people who built this place seem to have been the cautious type.
Hidden treasure, huh? Where do you think...
Save your speculation for another day, you two. We have a Therian to find.
Right. Sorry.
So, about that treasure.
Aizen!
We'll talk about this later, Lafayette.
All right.
So, that makes me wonder what lies in wait for us deeper in this place. I do wonder. Oh, there's our hoverboard. Above ground ruins. It looks like this, though. Let's see. I hate these scroll buttons. Okay, it looks like this side is a dead end, so maybe we should go back over there and check this side out first, maybe? Oh, we got a gold chest right here, though. Oh, there's two chests. Runner's High. Women's shoes guaranteed never to scuff, even after a 40k marathon. Nice. Let's see. I don't think anybody can actually needs them just yet, though, so. The store is being sealed shut by an unknown force. Okay. If you guys don't want to link together, I have no interest. I have no interest in you. Okay, yeah, I guess we're going to head up and we're going to go over to the other side first. Because I want to see, since that's a dead end, I want to see what is over there. Chances are probably a chest and maybe even a passageway to a dead end with some treasure or something like that would be nice. I really love the mobs in this area. Like, that is a creeper. It's like a dead Empyrean. Or, I mean, a dead Malakim. I mean, I don't know if it's actually dead. Maybe that's just how the Malakim is. It's just a creeper, but... I hear a specter somewhere, it sounds like. Maybe not.
I refuse to fall here.
Even still, these are not easy fights. We got a Naginata for Eleanor. A long weapon with an exotic appearance. It's technically not a spear, but it can be wielded like one. That's right. Alright, so... What's down this way? It looks like a dead end of some sort. I don't want to fight you, Spectre. I don't. Okay, that's just straight up dead end. There's no treasure to be had. Alright. Then what about off in... this direction. I've been finding a lot of Tails coins in this area. Oh, I have a feeling that that is our Nordahl. So, I do need all the XP that I can get from the easier fights if I hope to actually, like, master these ruins. Yeah, these look like cages for something. What do we got? Red Lavender, extra attack. Okay. Let's see. I'll give it to her. As per usual, I was debating between her or Rokuro, but his attack is actually fairly decent.
Just how does this sword work?
I wonder what's going to happen when we run into a dire foe here. Like, how much you want to bet it's a new one, and I bet it's going to be stout. Oh my gosh! I don't actually want you. I have a feeling that I did get you, in fact. So we're just going to have to go really, really heavy attack. And if any specters spawn, I think what I'm going to do is use my special on them. It's up to me. Okay, I think this is the last specter guy that we've got. Oh my god. This is bad. Oh man, we got a dire foe. Let's see what it is first. I have no life bottles though, and I'm down a person. I've got to run. So, cool. That means we used the last of our life bottles and pretty much came out of that battle in terrible shape, as you can tell, and didn't even get any XP out of it. My god, this place is awful. It's awful. I have a feeling, like, after this episode is done, Saturn Satchel. But I have a feeling that after this episode is done, I will be grinding a lot. Because, I mean, we are just getting steamrolled. Which, I mean, I understand the double battle is supposed to be more difficult, yada, yada, yada. But that's all we do is double battles. That's how we level, is double battles. So, I refuse to put myself in that situation where it's just too much. Alright, so let's see about this Nordahl.
Turtles! Turtles!
Sell me some boil life
oysters
bottles.
In the cloisters! Oh, got another letter for you, Aizen.
Okay.
Maybe it's from your sister this time.
You want to read it?
Me?
Please allow me. Now then.
Your cruelty knows no bounds. You bring deep sadness to a fair maiden's heart with each passing day. Repent, or else I'll be forced to intervene. This is your final warning.
And that's it.
Wow, this person sounds really mad.
Aizen, what did you go and do to make the fair maiden cry?
I don't know, but I could try a couple things on you.
Ooh, excuse me if I forget to be scared.
The letter mentions a fair maiden. Do you think it refers to your sister?
What?
Oh, you could be onto something. She must be lonely so far away from her brother.
It sounded like she's pretty fond of you.
Hmm.
Are you suggesting that Aizen's sister wrote these letters? I mean, they're certainly unusual, but...
My sister wouldn't write something like this.
Then maybe it's someone who's spending a lot of time around her. Like, oh, a man whose shoulder she cries on.
Damnation, Mogilu! My sister doesn't have any guy clinging onto her! Do you know something I don't? Prove it! Bring him here right now!
Calm down, Aizen. No one's saying that.
But if you're really that worried, why don't you go see her? Have you not done that since you left?
I did go back once, a long time ago. But as soon as I showed up, a crowd started to gather. Overcome by malevolence, they turned into demons and attacked my sister then and there.
Do you think it's your fault that happened?
What do you think? I'd moved us to a safe place, low in malevolence and high up a rugged mountainside.
So much for coincidence.
I haven't gone back to see her since.
Changing topics. I know I said these Nordals were a little off, but I think I'm starting to see that as part of their appeal.
Huh?
My point is, no matter how odd it might be, any gift could make a girl happy if it's given from the heart.
Ha. Sorry. You can't have one.
And our expedition has returned.
All right.
Still not. Oh my gosh. All right. Okay, we don't have any more side quests now. That's the last Nordal. Okay, so first off, I do apologize. That song that was playing whenever during that video, that was my cup. I totally forgot about it when I lifted it to take a drink of coffee that it's going to start playing that, it's going to start playing the Song of Time. So I do apologize. But anyways, I'm going to try to avoid doing any kind of double battle that involves a Spectre, I think, because it's too much. I have no life bottles left. Like, if somebody goes down now, well, that's too bad. We just have to just suck it up and go on, I guess. God, this place just is, it's so difficult. Like, I'm half tempted to leave the ruins and go get some more life bottles. Like, I would love a save point right now. That would be ideal, because if I die, I just lose everything. So, oh man. Okay, two bats. I can take two bats. But I cannot take that specter, so.
Don't get careless! Slow down!
Do not give me that specter. Okay, there we go. I'm gonna have to focus all my attacks on these specters and just make sure that they die first. Regardless of what we're fighting. I'm gonna finish off this bath though. That was a lot smoother. Builder of Water and Fire title, rank 2, and then we got sharp-edged paper. Paper sheets with edges so sharply trimmed that the unprepared will no doubt get paper cuts. Okay, let's see. Okay, he's still working on quartz paper, so. Oh my gosh. Yeah, I think a really good grinding session is in order. Like, in the very near future, because, like, people need grade to get stuff maxed, and we need levels to actually live at this point. I guess we'll head off in this direction. The battles over here look good, so. Oh, it's actually blocked off. Oh, there's a fire thingy right there. Alright, these guys aren't too bad. Oh, but we have some undying wretches. Those need to die first. I have a feeling, though, that the game is about to get really, really, really tough in comparison to the game so far. Because I think we're reaching that point, maybe, where battles start getting way tough.
I hope I did a good job.
It sure feels like it, thus far. So, Alright, so we're going to have to go light these lanterns real quick. Protective hops. Men's shoes developed for survival, resulting in increased standard and art defense. Nice. Okay, can I give those to Rokuro? He's got quartz boots. Okay, Aizen? No? Lafayette? No? Nobody wants them. Nobody needs them. But those armor guys will actually get up on the casters and just start wrecking them. So, like, I've got to just run around and just kill everything. Everything needs to die. So, oh man, it's tough. It's so tough. Alright, so let's check off in this direction. I almost hope that we're about done with this dungeon. I really want to save and get some life bottles and stuff. Would be great. Alright, looks like this is the last treasure chest for this area. Alright, two bats. I would like that battle, actually.
Let's get started.
But of course, we got an undying wretch in here. Look at Rokuro. He's like, I'm getting this. Oh, wow. We wrecked it. When me and Rokuro team up like that, we do some damage. I feel like we move extra fast at the beginning of the battle, I've noticed. Okay, so here we go. We had to light two to open the door, to come in and light that one to open the gate. So, good stuff. Alright, so now we're clear, I think, to head on out of this place. Or deeper into this place, I'm sorry. Please, save point, please. Or a turtles. That doesn't look like it. Uh-oh.
How's Medissa been acting?
She's calm. It looks like letting her in on the truth worked as well as we thought it might.
Good. Maybe she'll be easier to control now.
Eleanor's not terribly happy about this, I don't think.
Halt! Who are you?
We're your demise. Oh, man. Oh, great. We got two spirits and an armor. Okay, well, you know what I'm going to be focusing on then.
See this?
Gotta kill him. I got this one. Rokuro, you get the other one, please. Oh, yeah, there we go. Look at this. Just get wrecked.
Well, that about does it.
16 seconds. Okay. Can you imagine?
So, Medissa really is here.
But what's this about the truth and controlling her?
Can you imagine only doing single battles and, like, trying to level with that? Like, 400 XP compared to, like, 1,500 to 3,000 something. I mean, it's not even comparable. Like, at all. Okay, the door's open. Can I get you two together, please? Alright, once we finish this dungeon, depending on how tough, like, the next area is, I'll probably change tactics up and let them switch up. I don't mind them switching up, but in a place like this, I do not want them to switch. I refuse to allow them to switch. There's just too much at stake, you know what I mean?
Let's get started!
I almost feel like it'd be better kind of to grind in other places, too, that are a little bit safer. Because the XP, I mean, if you compare it to, like, some of the last places that we went to, it's not like, wow, it's so much better. But, like, the danger of death is just insane. Oh, man. It's so difficult. Okay. Looks like a way out right here of some sort. It's a big room here. And we have a save point. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, there's one thing. It's like find the hidden light things. Oh, at least we're able to save now. That, like, dying and then having to redo everything is a terrible thought, you know? Alright, hopefully there's a chest back through here. Otherwise, I missed one somewhere, but I've been thorough, I think. Red Verbena, it's defense. Okay, and we got a chest over there. Awesome. Okay, guess what? Lafayette's getting that defense. And we got a life bottle. Yay. It's like our backup just in case life bottle. Okay, this direction takes us to the ruins B1. I'm actually kind of curious to see what that is. Real quick. Because it looks like probably a Therian in there. Aha! I know where this is. This is like a halfway shortcut out of here. So there we go. That door is open now. And I guess we'll go take on the Therian. Hopefully we don't just get wrecked. Honestly, the bosses aren't too bad. It's just the double battles are generally the harder than the bosses and stuff, I think. So, uh-oh.
A barrier! She's a Therian!
Third time's the charm, eh, kid?
Yeah.
Barrier down. Are we gonna have to fight her? Surely.
You're Medissa?
I am. And who might you be?
We're like you. We carry grudges against the Abbey. And Shepherd Artorias.
It's gonna be okay. We came to get you out of here, Medissa.
There's no escape.
What? Please, don't give up.
No, you don't understand. There's no escape for you. If you dare sully Shepherd Artorias' ideals and the light the Abbey shines upon the world, I will kill you all!
Oh, God. The Queen of Snipes. Six snipes. Oh, these are easy.
She's the Abbey's lucky now.
Way to jinx it, Rokuro.
He did indeed. Now we got sea serpents. It's like all different kinds of snakes. Come on, this isn't difficult. Give us a real battle. We got a 0.94 grade and 86 XP for that. Awesome.
They just keep coming.
We one-shot
that snake
them.
Woman keeps summoning them. If we don't go after her directly, there'll be no end to it.
Huh. Your left hand. Don't tell me you're the Calamity.
Why are you doing this, Medissa? Why fight for the Abbey after they forced you to become a Therian?
They didn't. I became one of my own free will.
But your daughter, slain at an exorcist's hands! You must hate the Abbey for that, don't you?
Oh, I feel hate. Toward a world where demons spawn from the people's malevolence!
She even has snake fangs.
You know about malevolence?
The exorcist told me the truth. Diana turned into a demon because of the malevolence she radiated. I knew what I had to do. Become a Therian, and devour malevolence so that such a tragedy would never repeat itself. It matters not what dreadful form my body may take. I will revive Enominat and change this wretched world!
Good God!
If that's how it is, fine. We'll take you by force.
What if we have to kill her and they just replace her or something?
Going to end this. Her death will not be in vain.
Therian Medissa, level 42, and then we've got just rock golems. Those are only level 23s. I'll let the party take those and I'll stay on her. She's weak to earth and resistant to fire.
She's just a grieving mother.
It doesn't matter. Crush them all.
Double heat.
No mercy.
That's right.
That one heals.
Lethal pain. Oh my gosh. I was about to use that soul on her. And she just takes it from me. Get you some. Alright. Yeah, we're wrecking her.
Get it.
Oh my gosh! Every time I get a fourth soul, she takes it. I've been stunned. I'm petrified. There we go. Nope, you're not gonna stop me this time. You can hear Lafayette and them over there, like, I guess fighting. Oh, they're fighting snakes. So me and Rokuro are up on her.
I'm this close. I won't miss. Form zero. Thunder. Double
hit. No, you don't. I don't want that. Oh man. Well, she gave it to Rokuro. I can finish her off. Don't worry. A snake just steals my soul. There we go.
God.
It's over. Curse you, Lord of Calamity.
Lord of Calamity?
That's the name of the demon lord who will bring about the Age of Chaos. The unrepentant embodiment of malevolence, whose blind pursuit of self-gratification will rain destruction upon the world. The irredeemable, uncontrollable personification of human sins. An evil like you!
Demon, Therian, Lord of Calamity, call me whatever you like. But if I'm the supposed Lord of Demons, then you're just a minion to be used as I please. Nothing more.
No, I refuse. What happened to my Diana was my fault. That's why I will fight you until my dying breath!
Stop!
Don't get in my way!
No! Enough mothers have died. I won't let you join them!
Eleanor and Kamawana, they both lost their mothers too. It's a terrible thing.
Kamawana?
A little girl that the Abbey forcefully made into a Therian.
Her mother tried to save her, but she failed. All she could do was to offer her own life to fill her child's empty stomach.
Kamawana's been crying ever since. She misses her mother. If you die here, I can only imagine how sad that would make your Diana.
Diana!
You don't need me anymore, Mom. I get it. You love this new dad more than your own daughter!
No, honey. I did it for you. But you really thought I stopped loving you. And the malevolence made you into a demon. It's all my fault. I'm so sorry. Forgive me. Diana!
Medissa.
She'll be all right. She's just unconscious.
Let's grab her and haul her back.
I'll place her under a binding arc, just in case.
Gotta hand it to the Abbey. Very resourceful, taking advantage of Medissa's regrets like that. Making her into a Therian who would do their bidding.
It's just so cruel.
Who cares? Reason above all, no?
It's true.
I love her tale.
The way I feel goes against all reason. There's no telling what'll happen to Helaphys once we take Medissa out of here. And yet I'm doing exactly that, all on account of my own hang-ups. Even crushing Medissa's honest resolve.
According to reason, malevolence is the fault of the individual. You assume no responsibility or guilt for what happens to them.
I refuse to turn a blind eye to the consequences of my actions. I chose this path to seek the truth, not to deny it. If I'm to betray reason, then that is the very least I should do.
You're too much, you know that? You and Medissa both. Quit overthinking things. Just blame all the suffering on the Lord of Calamity. Makes life easier.
Velvet, I...
I'm not trying to cheer you up. I'm just saying it doesn't bother me. Whatever's coming, I can handle it.
Alright, we got an achievement, the Curious Youth. And quite a bit of XP, actually. Lafayette leveled. We got a 30.97 grade. Oh, we got a couple... Quite a bit of equipment skill mastery going on here. And the Superior Ignisite unlocks level 3 random skills. Nice. And our expedition has returned. What did we get? Fluffy milk. 16 fluffy milk. That's
Scout
it.
Ship depart.
Oh my gosh, I hate this place that we're exploring right now. And I'm sure you guys all got it, the Medusa thing. But I will say that I do know more about the Lord of Calamity than you guys probably do, unless you've played other Tales games. I do know more about it, but I can't say anything. Also, oh yeah, we maxed all this stuff. We got Quartz Blade maxed, which I think... I don't know... I'm going to go with the Feldspar Blade until we get the Quartz Blade leveled. The Quartz Blade will be better, it's just a, right now it's not. And then we can actually go with those Runner's High shoes. It looks like, let's see, 118 on Focus, 63 on Defense. So we'd lose Attack, but we'd gain... Well, we'd gain Defense, but we'd lose Focus too. But it's... We'll get the skill off of it at least. Quartz Waistcoat. I don't think there's anything really for him to change into. No, not really. Quartz Bag. He can now use that Saturn Satchel, which is Attack and Defense instead of Magic and Attack. Eh. Okay, and then the Quartz Paper he can trade out for the Sharp Edged Paper. And then those Featherlight Steps, I guess she can rock the Quartz Boots now. Or the Feldspar Boots. Or the Amphibole Boots. Okay, we're going to give her Amphibole first because she needs to get that stuff caught up. But then in addition, the master skill for the Amphibole Boots are actually pretty good. Alright, he maxed the Quartz Waistcoat, but I really don't think that he's got anything else to go to. Let's see. Actually, he's just about to max his boots. But anyways, he maxed the Gatling Arms, so now he can move on to the Feldspar, I guess, next. Okay, so everybody's sorted. I am going to end this episode out here because I know it's wrapping up point. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you did, as always, be sure and hit that like button and go ahead and subscribe if you're not already for more daily videos. I will say that between this episode and next, I'm probably going to do a bit of grinding. It's just to say the least. I'm probably going to leave and get some life bottles, then come back and do a bit of grinding because we are just absolutely getting wrecked. And fingers crossed that this expedition ends up finally getting that last item that we need, because we've been here at the Crystal Iron Sea for quite a while trying to get that last material. I mean, we're already about halfway through 16 towards 17. These Centurion Isles, it says this group of islands was once one solid landmass before it was shattered into dozens. Each island is now home to different monsters. Interesting. I wish we could actually go out and explore all those areas on foot. It would be so cool. Even if they weren't like massive, if they were just like little islands with something to do on it, it would still be pretty cool. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys are enjoying the series so far. I will say that that whole showdown with Medusa was actually pretty cool, I thought. And I hope to see you guys next time. So until then, as always, do take care, stay safe, and I will see you then.